Lesson 16, sensory organs. Now boys, we all know that we have 5 sensory organs. That is our eyes, ears, nose, skin and tongue. Okay, so these are our sensory organs. Let's learn more about it. Now, in this picture, the girl Tai is blindfolded. Then how can she tell what sound she is hearing? The boy is making a sound, but she is able to tell it. How is she able to tell? Her eyes are closed. How does she know what sound the boy is making? Correct, because she can hear. She has ears, right? She can hear with her ears. The ears are telling her what sound she is hearing. Now in the next picture, Tai is holding some things in the hand and she's giving the boy, she's asking the boy to tell what it is. Now even he is blindfolded, but how does he know? Correct. He can smell it with his nose. He can tell if it's a mango or a rose or a different flower. He can tell it with his nose. Now here both of them are blindfolded, but they are able to touch and tell what is in their hand. Because the hand can feel if it's a sweater or if it's a cotton shirt. Okay, so that our sensory organs are helping them to tell what is around them. So, we can tell what color a mango is with our, if it's a ripe mango, with the eyes. Eyes will tell us if the color of a mango is green or yellow. We can decide and tell if it's ripe or not. Then the taste of the salt or sugar, how do we know that? We know that with our tongue. If we taste it, it tells us that salt is sour and sugar is sweet. Okay, so our tongue tells us the taste of things. What is the sensory organs then? An organ that tells us about our surroundings is a sensory organ, something that tells us about our surrounding. Okay, so the eyes tells us about what we can see, the nose tells us what we can smell. Our eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin are our sensory organs or sense organs. Now, imagine this. You're walking on the road and there's a ditch ahead of you. You see the ditch and you decide, oh no, I'll fall into it. So you walk around it. But what would happen if you did not see the ditch? You would fall in the ditch, right? In the same way, you are playing out in the neighborhood and you suddenly hear a thunder. It's going to rain. So you run to the house before it rains. How did you know that these things were there around you? Because your sensory organs told you that there's a ditch. Your eyes told you there's a ditch ahead of you. Your ears told you that it's going to rain. So, it is our ears, eyes, nose, tongue and skin which tell us about our surrounding and keep us safe. It helps us to keep us safe, ourselves safe from what is going to happen. Now, so, how do we sense what is happening around us? It is our eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin which tell us about our surroundings. Therefore, they are called as sensory organs. Eyes. Now, it is with our eyes that we can see. We can tell the color of things. We can tell their shape. And we can also tell the distance of things from us. So because of eyes, we can tell if a thing is near or far. And we can tell the different colors of a thing. We can also tell the shape. So eyes helps us to identify the surroundings. Correct? If our eyes were closed, it would be very difficult for us to, you know, live as if now we are living. So eyes help us a lot. The next, ears. Now listen to the sound. our ears tell us whether the sound is sweet or harsh. In this case, it is not sweet, it is really harsh. So, we can differentiate if it is a sweet sound or a harsh sound. Then, it can tell us if the sound is of a bird or an animal. In this case, it is a sound of a bird. And the sound also tells us from what direction it is coming, a sound is coming from. Okay, we can hear somebody calling, so we will turn in that direction. So the eyes are the helps us to tell us which sound the direction is coming from. The ears, I'm sorry. The next is our nose. We can smell with our nose. We can smell a fragrant of flowers or an incense stick because of our nose. Again, it is the nose which tells us if there's a foul smell or that if food is spoilt. At such times, we take proper precautions. So, if there's a foul smell coming or if a food is spoilt, we can come to know with the help of our nose. Our nose then can tell us, oh, this food is spoilt, we should not eat it. So, in this way, our nose helps us to do many things. The next is a tongue. Tongue helps us to tell the taste of things. It can tell us if something is sweet or sour. It can tell us if something is bitter, like a bitter gourd, which is karela, is very bitter, right? It can tell us if something is sour or spicy. Chilies are spicy. Okay? Now, salt is salty. This we come to know because of our tongue. Now, when we eat a chili, we get a burning sensation on our tongue, which tells us that the chili is very hot. Okay? Spicy also means hot. Now, the next sensory organ is a skin. Now, tell me, there's this game called What's in the Box. So, you stand behind a box and there's a thing kept in, there are some things kept inside the box and you have to put your hand. Without seeing, you have to guess what are you feeling. So, in this case, the boy is holding a tomato. But he's just not able to see the tomato. He has to feel and tell it. In this case, there are many other things that are there down, which one by one we will try to pick it up and try to feel and tell. So this helps us to check if really we can see without, tell without seeing. Okay? Skin. Now we can tell if something is hot or cold, or if something is smooth or rough with the help of our skin. Skin is another sensory organ which will tell us if you are feeling hot or cold, if how is the weather, you know. So the skin helps us decide on the temperature of some things. Now in this picture, this lady is making food. One hand she has got the spoon, in the other hand she has got the tongs. Tongs is the pakkad. Okay, then she is serving now with one hand. Okay, she is using a spoon to remove the things in the plate. Now her eyes are on the food. She can smell the food if it is ready or not. So she is using all her parts of the body together in this. Okay, if she was not seeing, if she was not smelling, the food could have got burned. That is why coordination is required when we are doing any work. If there is no coordination, there can be mistakes. Okay? Lack of coordination can cause mistake. Now, overcoming disability. If our body does not function well, we face many difficulties. If our eyes do not function well, we cannot see properly. If our ears do not work well, we cannot hear well. In such a situation, our bodies are not able to work smoothly. We find it difficult to do things on our own. But such situations can be overcome. We can make some corrections. Some difficulties can be corrected by medical treatment. In some others, we can take the help of other people. Some special devices can also be used to overcome the disability. Then it becomes possible to carry out our own tasks independently. If we cannot see well, we use spectacles, right? And if we cannot see at all, then we use the help of a stick and also some other person's help to help us around. Have you seen a blind person, how they use a stick to walk around? So if you see a blind person, please try to help them, okay? Now if you cannot hear, we have a hearing aid. And those who cannot hear at all, they use the sign language. In some cases, a surgery is also performed. Now there's another difficulty. If there's a defect in the leg, the person uses a wheelchair so that the person can move around. This makes the person independent, not dependent on others. Okay, so what have we learned in this lesson was, we have learned that our sensory organs tells us about the situation all around us. The eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin are our five sensory organs. We can see with our eyes, hear with our ears, smell with our nose, we taste things with our tongue and feel them with our skin. When we work, we need to have coordination in all the tasks. Difficulties may arise due to lack of coordination. If any organ does not function well, we may face difficulties in doing our work. We must not give up in the face of difficulties. They can be overcome. So what have we learned in this lesson, boys? Always remember, if there is a disability in any organ, we can find a way out of that difficulty. We can learn to be self-reliant, which means if there is something that you cannot do, learn to do it in some other way and be independent. Don't depend on others to do things for you, because then every time you will want somebody around you. So learn to do things on your own where you do not need somebody's help every time. Okay? Hope you have enjoyed this lesson, boys.